Success is simply a matter of luck. Ask any failure. Earl Wilson. No, success is not a matter of luck. Yes, we love to have fortune on our side and God's good blessings, but you need to work at it every single day. Pray and row away from the rocks. I love that. What we do here every day, not only pray, but we also follow these markets. 10 to 15 minutes a day is all we ask of your time. But that's every day the markets are open. Why? Because it's so important that every day you get your feet wet, you understand what's going on, you follow what's happening in your favorite stocks, your favorite ETFs, those things that you're interested in. Here, we have four ETFs. We have the S&P 500 up for the day. We have the NASDAQ 100 up for the day. We have 20-year bonds up for the day, and we have gold up for the day. This is odd. This is not the way things are supposed to be. Typically, when stocks are up, one would think that gold and bonds should be down. They're more safe havens. They're places where money flows to when things aren't doing so well. The opposite is true. When things aren't doing well, gold and bonds is where money goes. We would expect them to be going up. Not all of them going up, so it is a bit of an anomaly today. That happens. And again, we are going to jump into these charts and explain more about what's going on. Those of you just joining us, please go to our website, chartingwealth.com. Sign up every day to receive all the special trainings, the daily reviews that we're doing right now for you. And for those who are subscribers, and it's for free, we have the third installment. This is part three of Options Made Simple, the Charting Wealth Way, how to practice trade options to supercharge your trading. Okay, jump into that. Take that. You will enjoy it. You want to know what options are all about. This is part three of that training, available if you are a subscriber for free at chartingwealth.com. Let's jump into these charts. What do we see going on? We always start with the weekly chart. What do we see going on here? We see the markets are reaching a higher high. It's Thursday, one more day in this shortened week. The derivative oscillator gaining upward momentum. Price percent oscillator still heading up. We have a green up candle. Price is above the two-day and above the weekly. That's good to see. We go to the two-day. What do we see there? We have a red spinning top. Now, don't forget, the last two-day candle formed on Wednesday. This is the first day of the latest. It will finish forming on Friday. We have a red spinning top, means indecision tending down. It's not a solid red candle, but again, cautionary. What do we see happening as far as the price percent oscillator goes? Weak. It's still positive. Derivative oscillator losing momentum, so we're keeping that in mind. We look at the four-hour chart. Went negative this morning. In the afternoon, again, lots of indecision. Derivative oscillator gaining downward momentum. Price percent oscillator down. Green spinning top. I'm sorry, almost a doji. Indecision possibly tending up, but after a big down morning. That's where we are on the S&P. Things weakening. Again, up for the day, 0.11%. What do we see on the Qs? Again, Qs reaching a higher high. Price above the two-day and the weekly. Derivative oscillator like stair steps continuing to gain energy. Go from the two-weekly to the two-day. And we see so far the 2 days not reached a higher high. The high, 224.69. The prior high, 225.15. Consequently, the price percent oscillator flat, heading down maybe a little bit. Derivative oscillator gaining some momentum. Go to the four-hour chart. We see things down in the morning, bit of a recovery in the afternoon. Green spinning top, indecision tending up. Look at that. Look at the derivative oscillator. It's gone negative. Doesn't mean it can't swing back over to the positive, but it has gone negative. And of course, the price percent oscillator went negative in the morning. So again, a little bit of weakness we're seeing. Not that stocks can't recover from that. Pay attention to that. When we leave stocks, look at what was up the most for the day. That's bonds, which typically move inverse to stocks. Is this portending, foretelling us that stocks are getting ready to roll over, going down? don't necessarily know that, but we can see that bonds are gaining some energy. Doesn't look like we're going to have a weekly vertical crossover by the end of this week, but we see the price percent oscillator heading up, still negative. Derivative oscillator still negative, but losing downward momentum. We have a green candle that's forming for the week with a big wick on top. We go from the weekly to the 2-day that, of course, crossed over going up back on the 10th. That represented Thursday the 9th, Friday the 10th of January. And really, price has just been moving right up that 2-day trend line, spiking up over the last, 5 days now. Derivative oscillator gaining upward momentum. Price percent oscillator heading up. Go to the 4-hour chart. What do we see there? Up movement, strong up movement in the morning, a little bit tempered in the afternoon. Price percent oscillator heading up, derivative oscillator heading up. So we'll pay attention, see what's going on. No trade there on bonds. Why? Because the 2-day is up, the weekly is still down. We'll wait for one of those, either the long term, the weekly, to move in the same direction of the 2-day, or the 2-day to recross back over in the direction of the weekly. We'll see how that works out. What about gold? Gold is up for the day 0.22%. We have a green candle that is forming for the week, but the high in the prior week, all the way back, the week ending the 10th, wasn't a big week. This last week ending the 17th of January, back on the 10th of January, the high was 148.61. So far, the high is 147.62, so about a dollar difference there, not hitting a higher high. However, derivative oscillator moving up, price percent oscillator moving up. So the weekly chart, as far as our oscillators go, particularly that all-important price percent oscillator, looks decent. What's going on the 2-day chart? Well, it's about flat. We do, as far as the price percent oscillator goes, derivative oscillator continuing to lose upward momentum. We see, however, the Heiken Ashi candlestick is trying to move up. It's the biggest green candlestick we've seen in a while. And again, not finished drawing. We'll see how things finish on Friday. But again, nice green up candle right now after a real sideways slide since things peaked back on the 2-day candle ending Wednesday, the 8th of January. So we'll see how this continues to move. What about the 4-hour chart? 4-hour chart's not yet crossed over, going up. It is still negative, getting closer and closer. Derivative oscillator flipped over, going up back in the afternoon on Tuesday of this week. So again, waiting to see if that price percent oscillator is going to cross. That's where we are, folks, as we end the day on Thursday, go into Friday. Don't forget, close the market on Friday. We'll be recording our comprehensive review and forecast for the week. Hope you enjoy that options training for the day. You want to support us in our work? Buy our book, Charting Your Way to Wealth, a great introduction to what we do here every day. Follow the link in the show notes, either the ones you receive in your email every day or at the website chartingwealth.com. You'll see the links there or at our YouTube channel. Thank you so much, my friends. Also appreciate all your Patreon support. If you're listening, watching on YouTube, please do click that subscribe button. God bless. All the best from the whole team at Charting Wealth World Headquarters.